first one is the belt, and this is what goes around your waist. So we have a basic model here, where the belt is padded. The belt should always be padded. And here, as you can see, it's quite narrow, and it just basically hooks around you, very simply. The second model, again, padded, but as you can see, a little wider, so you have a bit more support for the lumbar region. This is the one I use, and the same closing mechanism here, very, very simple. Okay, so that's for the human. Then, looking at the dog's equipment, the dog's going to wear a harness, whether he's walking or running. Here I've got a couple of types to show you. Important here, the same as with the human belt, important that you have some padding to protect the dog when he's pulling. You don't want anything sharp that's going to pull on the shoulder and the back of the dog. So always a bit of padding is good. This is an intermediate sort of level of harness in terms of the quality and the performance, but perfectly adequate, and as you will see later, very easy to put on. And here we have another type, which is for maybe more advanced users. Here it's one that I'd fitted to my Weimar underdog, so it really fits up really nice and snug, so you get the most pull when you run. Again, we get padding everywhere. Yeah, reflective pads here for running in the dark if you decide to do so, and here it's a bit more ergonomic, but this would be a bit more for more advanced users. This model here, the first model, is just your classic harness. Okay, and then of course, to make the link between us and the dog, what we have is a bungee lead. So it's really this sort of thing, elasticated. One end ties to your belt, and one end goes on to the harness for the dog. Okay, so a couple of options. You can get one with a little handle to help you handling the dog. Basic model, always the bungee. So this is like your shock absorber between you. So let me show you how we put the harness on. So the first thing you need to locate is this metal loop here, which is the loop where we're going to hook our bungee rope on. So this is going to go on the back of the dog. And this part here is going to be where we fit the harness through the head of the dog. So if we put it like this, and simply over the head, okay? This part here is going to run along the chest, and we have our two straps here. So along the chest, up, good gap, and then we bring up the two straps here, okay, and just simply click on each side, they stay here, on the right and on the left, that's it, job done, loop is on the top. So here, just looking at the size of the harness, I'm just going to show you here, this harness is set for the size of my other dog, which I run and walk with. She's a black lab from my local shelter, Apasa. She's a bigger dog than Misty. So here, this harness doesn't fit Misty, and I'll show you why. If we look here at the size, this, you see, is really far too loose here and there. So a nice fitting harness, really, you should just be able to slide your hand under here and under there. Simply just to adjust the harness, pull on the straps, and adjust as you would any normal straps on a rucksack. Very, very simple. But here it was just to demonstrate that simple procedure to put the harness on. And before we go for a walk, I just wanted to briefly show you the belt that I wear, which, you know, again, uses the same mechanism. So you have a first clip, like so, that goes around your waist, and then you have your second clip, again, same thing with our little loop, where we're going to hold on and tie on a bungee rope, so, like so. Really, simply here, and obviously this one goes onto the harness of the dog. Just one little tip, you see that the bungee is in two parts. The first part is a stand strap or a rope, and the second one is the bungee part. Make sure that you fit it this way so that you can actually hold on to the strap and the hard strap just when you're going to steer the dog to the left, to the right, and also when you're going to brake with the dog, rather than holding on to the bungee, of course, which you wouldn't be comfortable in holding. So just make sure you fit it this way from your belt, then the strap and the bungee. Okay, so next step, we're going to go for a quick walk.